MPs and senators descended on Parliament House this morning.
G'day.
Morning.
Morning, how are you?
Top of the morning, how are you?
And so did protesters, charging the PM's car. After a six-week sitting recess, attention now firmly fixed on whether the Nationals will agree to a net zero emissions target for 2050.
Currently, it is a no. We'll continue to have discussions.
Before the PM flies off to the climate summit next week.
I'm not going to give a time constraint.
This morning, the Liberal Party room ticked off on net zero.
A plan that focuses on technology, not taxes.
Nationals met yesterday and again today, but still no decision.
This is not something that's going to happen in a great rush. We're going to make sure it's a diligent process.
The National Party's interest is very similar to our interest.
To expect us to make a decision within 4 hours is a little presumptuous.
Our regions are being held back by the biggest bunch of bullshit artists in this government.
Scott Morrison doesn't need the Nationals' approval to go to Glasgow and sign up to net zero.
Make it a free, conscious vote on the floor of the House of Representatives.
He also doesn't need the Parliament because the Coalition's plan does not include legislating the target.
But unless it's legislated, it can't be taken seriously.
The PM does need Cabinet approval, which includes senior Nationals loath to divide their party.
It's not a case of holding anybody to ransom or anything like that.
Labor used every question today to attack the Coalition for its record on climate change.
I thought this was question time, not sledge time, Mr Speaker, but if that's how the Leader of the Opposition wants to kick off the week, well, that's up to him.
Describing renewable energy targets as, quote, nuts. Why should Australians trust anything this Prime Minister says?
When I give a commitment to the Australian people about what we're going to do on emissions reduction targets, we keep it. That's right.
Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.